Welcome to St Mark's Church of England School. This video will hopefully give you a short insight into life at our wonderful, fully inclusive Church of England School.
Hello, my name is Stephanie Bryant and I'm the very proud head teacher of St Mark's Church of England School. Currently we are a primary school serving age 4 to 11, but from September 2022 we will begin to open our doors to Year 7 students as we build up to the first all-through school in Southampton, serving children from the age of 4 all the way up to 16.
St Mark's is currently housed in a temporary building that was completed in October 2020, whilst our new all-through school is being built. This is a £38 million investment by Southampton City Council to give our children a brighter future. As a Church of England school, our Christian ethos is very important to us. We live our lives based on our Christian values of love, equality, inclusion, and respect. In Year R, we use a variety of teaching methods and strategies in order to engage and enthuse our youngest learners, a mixture of formal, informal, and most importantly, play-related learning. We engage fully in the early years curriculum, which will be new in 2021, so your children will be the first children and cohort to try out the brand new curriculum that is being published by the government. However, we are getting prepared for that now to make sure there's no time lost. Our children currently, as I said, housed in a temporary building. They have soon made it their home. Your children will be in this building for the first term of their school, but then will move over to their permanent home, getting used to it. As you can see, our children have great fun in Year R, with a mixture of whole class engagement and supported individualised learning, and through lots of play. We have a large outside area currently, which the children absolutely love, especially with their physical development, and which is brilliant for our Year R's. They get to experience life on our mugger pitch, which they would never normally experience until Year 7.
Green, well done. What can we see? Diagraph. Look in the middle of the word, what diagraph can we see? What can you see, Lena? Well done, let's go.
At St Mark's, we follow the order established in the phonics programme Letters and Sounds to plan our own progression of phonics lessons across EYFS and Key Stage 1. However, the rigour and structure of our approach means that children who continue to need phonics support in Key Stage 2 will receive so. Also, we use actions from Dolly Phonics to support teaching and learning. For the first 3 weeks of the year, Year R will follow Phase 1 of Letters and Sounds. This is to develop their speaking and listening skills, laying the foundations for phase two. By week three, phase two will begin, with sound of the day being sent home so that parents can continue to support with learning at home. This continues in Key Stage 1. At the end of Year 1, the children will complete a phonics screening to assess their ability to segment and blend words. However, alongside teaching the children to segment and blend, our approach ensures that children are taught high-frequency words that do not correspond with regular phonic patterns. Independence and confidence is also built so children can spell words using their phonic strategies.
Good girl. What's at the end of Mina?
Bright.
Oh, should we do it all together?
Yeah.
Bright.
Well done.
Bright.
Let's see if we can find another one.
At St Mark's, we pride ourselves on offering a rich and varied curriculum, unique to us as a school and enhanced with trips, visitors and real life experiences. We are innovative in our teaching approaches and we are always striving to be the best that we can be. Our curriculum intent at St Mark's endeavours to ensure that all children can remember and understand the knowledge that they are taught in every subject. For us, learning to be a historian, an artist, or a scientist is just as important as becoming confident readers, writers, and mathematicians. We are inclusive and ambitious in our ethos to teaching and learning, and we have a fantastic teaching staff ready to meet the needs of every child.
Seven.
Oh, you're seven.
Oh,
seven.
A seven. Who gets it?
can help Georgiana out with a 7.
Well, last words, murky at the end. It's kind of like mist in the morning desert, really nice. Bottom shift. Jumping wildly over the bridge. Why did you choose wildly? As part of our active play programme. Okay. Well, you're going to be here in the hall where we do dance and gymnastics. Against other schools, and we even host schools here. As I said, PE is an integral part of what we do here at St Mark's, and we're really, really proud of what we achieve.
Hello, my name is Miss Loveridge, and I'm a deputy head at St Mark's. At St Mark's, we believe it's really important that all of our children, from year one right up to year six, understand the importance of behaviours for learning. As teachers, we feel it's our responsibility to make sure in the classroom all children have the same opportunities. And this means academically and socially. So for order to your child to get the best out of school, it is important that we teach them the things that we expect to see in the classroom. This might mean how they sit on the carpet and how they interact with their peers, both in the classroom and outside during social times. At St Mark's, we use something called PBS, or Positive Behaviour Strategy. And that's a real hands-on, practical way of ensuring that your child has strong, positive role models to follow. Your child's teacher will teach the children in the class exactly what they expect to see and how your child can actually go about achieving that. This might be from sitting on the carpet, from working independently, or working in sharing with groups of friends. Every class has a behaviour board. And in the morning, each child has a little peg and everyone starts on Let's Learn. And then depending on what they do during the day, they have opportunities of moving up the board and getting certificates when they reach the top. Children are really proud when they get their certificate to take home to their parents. How this works is the teachers will be teaching your child what's expected. And then when we see your child actually following that, your child's teacher will say, excellent, superb learning behaviour, go and move your peg up. And your child will move the peg up the board until hopefully they reach the top and bring home certificates to you. Now, sometimes children make mistakes. That's all a part of learning and growing up. And mistakes are good, because if we don't make mistakes, we'll never learn. And in order to help our children learn how to behave, sometimes a child might have to move their peg down. It might be that they've done something that their friends are upset by. It might be something that they've not done correctly. But in order to help your child learn, we carefully make them help them to think about what they've done and ask them, what do you think you could do in order to put it right next time? And through careful and gentle guidance, your child will then be able to move back up the ladder, back up to Let's Learn, and continue their positive journey to the top. Now, sometimes it might be necessary for your child's teacher to either give you a phone call or speak to you at the end of the day. That might mean that for this particular day, your child has found it difficult, has struggled. And it might mean that your child has ended up at the bottom on critical contact. That's nothing to worry about. All children are here to learn and all children will make mistakes. That's an inevitable part of growing up. But what we do at St Mark's is we carefully sit down with the child and talk to them about where they might have made a mistake and help them to put it right. Give them guidance and give them strategies in order to do that. So your child, even if they get down to critical contact, they still have the opportunity to move up the board. And we have had children who've been right at the bottom 1 minute and through careful guidance by the teachers have actually progressed back up the board into positive behaviour. It's really important that if it's asked if your child is struggling at home or struggling at school and anything we can do to help, you need to let us know. If you notice anything, please talk to your child's teacher, because together as a team we can help your child settle into St Mark's and become strong, positive learners.
Child due to start school in September and you've got any concerns about their learning or development, then we can help you to look at their strengths and difficulties. We've got an experienced inclusion team at St Mark's and we work with a lot of external specialists to look at speech, how their physical skills are developing and their learning. If we feel that a child might benefit from some specific support in school, then we can look at extra resources and maybe adult support that would look a bit different in the classroom to normal. If it's at a level where we feel we need extra support with that, then we can apply to the local authority and get extra support at a greater level. So if you've got any concerns, anything significant that you're worried about, then please get in touch with us or put it on the admissions forms for your children for when they start school. Thank you.
I hope this video has given you an insight into what life is like at St Mark's C of E School. I'm really proud of the children and staff here and what we managed to achieve. We are one big family and we're here to mutually support one another and we're here to support you. So if you have any questions about the application process, about life at St Mark's or about how we could support you and your child as we start on the school journey together, then please do not hesitate to call. If you're still undecided and would like a bit more information, please note that we have Facebook, Instagram and Twitter accounts where you can see more day-to-day life of the school and how we communicate things. And also there is our website which you can get lots of information from too about our curriculum offer and how we support children. Thank you very much for watching.